Welcome to the Alchemy of Ascension Summit. I'm your host, Waxela Sananda, and this is where we learn to raise our frequency so that you can connect with yourself more deeply, with your soulmate, and with the divine. And it is my pleasure today to introduce you to Janet Miller. But first, please join me for an alignment process so that we can all get completely present and just ready to receive whatever is in this conversation that's for your highest good today. So begin by closing your eyes and just relax into your body. And take a deep breath into your belly. And as you're inhaling, allow your belly to expand out. And on the exhale, contract your belly. And just continue to breathe and relax. And tune your awareness into your heart center and the light within your heart. This is your heart light. Feel it glowing and growing out around your heart. And now tune your awareness into the central sun far above your head. This is the source of divine masculine energy in the heart of the central sun. And bring the heart light of the masculine energy down into the top of your head, all the way to the bottom of your feet, and then back up, joining with the light in your heart, balancing and aligning you with the sun. And now tune in to the heart center of the earth. This is the divine feminine heart of the Mother Earth. And feel the light in the center of the earth, in the heart of the mother. This is the divine feminine. And you can picture it growing up through the layers of the earth as if on roots, carrying liquid crystal plasma, the essence nurturing energy of the divine mother. And feel that moving into the base of your spine and the bottoms of your feet. And breathe that up to the top of your head. And then bring that heart of the divine Mother Earth energy into your heart light. And let it join with the light from above and the light within you, creating a trinity portal of light within your chest. And then expand your heart light out around your body. And expand it out to connect with every other person listening or watching at this time and across all time and space. And connect in to my energy and to Janet's energy, knowing that we are here to support you and we are all on this ascension journey together. We are all ascending and doing our spiritual work together so that we can help raise each other. You are not alone in this process. So thank you for joining me in that. You can open your eyes and hopefully you're more present and grounded now. And it is my pleasure to introduce to you Janet Miller. Welcome, Janet. I'll let you say hello, and then I'll introduce you. I'll talk more about what you do.
Hi, Waxela. Thank you so much for that beautiful grounding exercise. That was really wonderful.
My pleasure. Janet, you're known as a divine light activator. I love that title. An LPN, an intuitive energy healer, and a certified holistic health practitioner. I love that, and I'm so excited to dive in with you and learn about what it is that you do. You've done a lot of things, but let's start at the beginning. What is it that caused you to get into this spiritual work and begin to do energy work? Did you have one big awakening experience, or did you have a gradual awakening experience?
Well, that's a great question, Waxela. Yeah, well, you know, we all start from that wounded place in our life. When, you know, childhood always seems to bring us that energy of something that causes us to connect eventually to our spiritual path. So, you know, growing up in the childhood trauma of, you know, alcoholic family, I, you know, took off on my own when I was in my late teens and just decided to make it for myself, just get there and get, you know, get out on my own and try to, you know, make a life for myself. And I was always curious as a child, you know, even as a teenager, I was curious, you know, when people were, you know, the hippie, I was in the realm of the hippies in the 60s, I was growing up and, you know, drugs was huge and, you know, psychedelic was big and, you know, the music was incredible and it was just the most magical age. I have to say, I was really blessed to be in that age because it was such a heart opening age. I mean, people, you know, everything was about love and the Beatles and, you know, the Rolling Stones. I mean, we were in that era, Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin. I mean, these are my people. And so that just lit me up. And I just, you know, I love music. So I was really into the music. It opened my heart. But then I would be curious, you know, I was curious about psychedelics, but I didn't do it because I was like, knowing my family addiction, forget about it. I was never going to come back if I started going that way. So, you know, you dabble a little here and there in life, but yet I did get into the alcohol. So mm-hmm. I got down the rabbit hole of that journey. And so in my 40s, my 39th year, I just woke up and I knew it was time. I needed something. I wasn't going anywhere I wanted to go. And I just got sober. So got sober 39 and been sober 27 years this year. And, you know, the most beautiful gift was getting sober because I was able to let go of the shame and the blame and the guilt and, you know, I'm not good enough. But, you know, I think that we're always getting that stuff in our heads. We still have to work with that. But yet, I let go of so much and my life opened up. And then Reiki came into my life. You know, the 12-step groups got me on a spiritual path. I was in that for years. I still am. I highly believe in the support system of it. It's magical. When you're in the right group, you really get the support you need. And yet it opened up the spiritual doors. And I got into Reiki and knew that I needed more. I went on to healing school, then got into reconnective healing and sound healing and now I'm doing soul purpose work and I did some dream coach work. And I mean, you name it, I've tried, you know, different things because I feel it was so important to fill up my toolkit for people. And then I started working with people and knowing the pain that I released, I wanted to help people do the same thing. So that was so important for me to help people release that pain. And so, you know, here we are now in 2020, which is the new age of Aquarius. And it's such a fantastic decade that we're opening up to. And, you know, this is a foundational year. It's a 2020 is a 4 year. It's a foundational year. Four is a foundational number, like the chair, you know, the feet of a chair, there's four legs of a chair. It gives you that stability. So everyone's bringing, you know, this year is like a huge year to bring in your foundation, like to start really looking at what do you want to build? You know, last year was huge of releasing a lot of old energies. I mean, we had all those eclipses and constantly digging deeper and deeper and deeper and digging it all up. And now it's time to let it go. And you know, if there's things left, you know, don't try to crush it away and stuff it away. This is the old thinking of, you know, stuffing things. And that's what gets us sick. You know, that's what causes the dis-ease in the body. And it's so important to, you know, get through that stuff. And if you can't do it alone, get the help. I mean, I couldn't do it all alone. I had to reach out for help. I mean, constantly. I still do. And I think it's so important for people to work with each other. I mean, we're a community. And I think the community of, you know, this unity energy that's coming through now is so important too, because we learn so much about how we're so connected. I mean, you know, with the internet and the world so connected now, everybody knows everything that's going on, if you're willing to, if you're open to it, if you want to. And you can also go down that tunnel of not ever looking and seeing what's going on. But if you're really open and your heart's open and you're ready for this, so much is available. And there's so many people willing to help, so many ways you can get help. And I know for me, it was just magical. It was magical.
Beautiful. Thank you for sharing all of that. I know for a lot of people, the 12-step recovery program does lead them to open up spiritually and to connect with the divine, or, you know, their spirit in a higher way. So it's beautiful that did like that for you. It sounds like you were already open and you got to experience such a fun time in our history of, you know, all of those amazing artists and musicians and the flower children. And I love that. I love that whole area of, if I could choose a time to revisit, I would definitely go back there and be at Woodstock and all of that fun stuff. But so you did all these things and experimented and learned a lot of different healing modalities and Reiki. So now do you have a way that's specifically your own that you work with clients, and what does that look like? Or what would an experience look like if I came to you for a healing session?
Well, I found that everyone, you know, I seem to be the one to help people open up their spiritual path. And so that's why the name Divine Light Activator came in, because it was all about helping people who are just starting to look at their life and like, oh, there's something more here. This is where I need to go. So when they come in with me, I always work with the chakras, but my basic healing was always starting with the chakras, but now my work is expanding because I do a lot of visionary work, especially when you're going on a global presence. Now you're going online and you're working with people all over the world. You know, working online changes your whole life and it changes the whole way you approach things. And it's wonderful because we're delving into areas that just open people up, and the visions that come through a lot. So, I can't say I'm a channel in a way, but I don't actually channel anybody in particular, but I'm just bringing through so much information that it just helps people with a lot of clarity. It helps people with, knowing what the next step could be, and it gets them on the path because, the new energy, there really is no steps. It's all about taking that next step, and that next step, then the universe starts supporting you because there's no path laid out. We're in a place where they didn't know we'd get to. Like the universe said, are you going to get there? And we got there. You know, our mass consciousness said, okay, these people really want this. And we've changed so many things on our planet. I mean, just opening up this energy of, learning to love yourself. I mean, my whole premise is self-love. My whole belief is that it's so important to love who you are. And that's why when I got into the 12-step programs, it helped me learn to love myself again. And so that's what I bring to people, is to learn how to love yourself again. Because once you can love yourself, then you can bring it out to everyone else in the world. I mean, you can't fill anyone else's cup or help them out when you're in a dry well. I mean, you can't. There's nothing there. It's like, you need the IV, or you need the drink of water. You need something to fill up that empty cup. And so spirituality is what did that for me. And it got me to love myself. And as I said, letting go of the shame. And so once I got into that, I started filling up with this amazing energy of compassion and understanding. And then you look at the things that have happened in your life and you can look at it in ways and say, wow, okay, that's the best I could do at that time. That's all I knew at that time. And, that alone is just an understanding that you have compassion for yourself, because that's all you knew. You didn't know anymore. So, we beat ourselves up. We look at ourselves and say, wow, I wish I did this. And I should have done that. Shoulda. There's no shoulds. I mean, we should ourselves to death. Right. And, it's not going to help us get anywhere. So the way to look at yourself, own it, to be responsible for your actions. That's a huge thing, to be responsible for what you're doing and what you've done, and just say, okay, that's all I knew at the time. And the people around me, that's all they knew at the time. And once you start shifting, then the people around you start shifting, because you change the way you interact with them. You just naturally start changing. And so it just spreads out. It's like the pebble in the pond. It's like, that kind of thing, the 100 monkey theory, where this monkey's cleaning off the potato, and then the next, all of a sudden it jumps over to the next island and they're all starting to clean off their potatoes. And all of a sudden, you know, this is a mass consciousness thing of the, you know, of the monkeys in the planet. So that's what's happening with all of us, that we're doing that. We're starting to learn to love ourselves and to say, yes, we need, you know, we love ourselves enough that we want more on this planet. We want peace on this planet. We want a nice environment. We want healthy, we want children that are healthy. We want, you know, a life that's good, and people to care about each other. And because we get pulled away, we get very isolated with the technology. We can get very isolated with it. And so I think the spiritual work brings us back together as a community to look at yourself, and the self-love helps you reach out to people more and connect with people once you love who you are.
Oh yeah, that's beautiful that you're helping guide people to self-love, because that's where it all begins. You know, if you don't love yourself, you can't really love anything or anybody else. You've got to start at home, and you have to clear out that old baggage before you can open up to the really good stuff. So that is a beautiful service that you're doing. You did an online show. Actually, you've done two of them, called Own Your Divine Light. That's how I found you. So can you tell us about what is Own Your Divine Light about? And then I'd love to hear, I know you've interviewed a number of spiritual people, and I'd love to hear, what are some of the most powerful things, nuggets of, like, golden nuggets that you received out of doing that show?
Yeah, Own Your Divine Light came from the whole thought of self-love. And I thought to myself, what is it that I want people to, you know, connect with me on? What is it I need to bring out to the world? What's my message? So my message is to the world was to how to own your divine light. And owning your divine light to me is your self-love, is owning your own essence, loving who you are. And that's your God essence, which is, you know, source love. To me, God is love. It's an energy. And so, you know, I say unlock your passion. So to help you unlock your passion, that's what I brought into the show. People who could talk about what we're talking about in so many ways, to what happened in your life, what brought you to where you are now, because we all grow from our wounds. We all learn through pain, because being in the 3D polarity energies, it's all, you know, good, bad, right, wrong. And now we're moving into the fifth dimensional energy. The new age is here, the fifth dimensional, the living from the heart, and being able to look at things with compassion. And we're all moving into that. And this is what the age has opened up since last year. It's technically, they say it's around the planet now. Different people, you know, Elizabeth Peru out of Australia. I did not interview her, but I love her work too. She has brought that through, and she's an amazing channel for people to learn about, you know, the new energies. But what did I learn? So so unlocking your passion was a huge thing for me to help people learn. And so these people would talk about their passions, and then igniting your authenticity. So when you start connecting with who you truly are and to loving who you truly are, then that helps you connect with what you love in your life, and you become more real of who you truly are. I mean, doing these kinds of things in my life, I never thought I'd be on an online show. I never thought I'd produce a show. I mean, that was never in my consciousness, but, you know, it came through. And, you know, this is what I mean by, you don't know what's next coming up in your life anymore. Mm-hmm. Just take the step and things start to unfold, and you have to take a leap of faith. It's all about taking a leap of faith, because when you take that leap of faith, then the universe supports you, because you're saying, okay, this is what I'm ready for. I'm ready for this next step. And it comes to you. So you have to be very present, listening to what's going on around you, the synchronicities in your life. It could be songs. I mean, you know, you're not going to get this spiritual being necessarily show up in front of you, which some people do, but it didn't happen to me. People will show up in front of you, or you'll get this energy, or you'll get this song come through, or you'll get a sign, or, you know, you'll say a prayer and you'll get an answer, or you'll sit in meditation. You'll say, okay, I really need this. And you listen and you get a dream. Dreams can be answers too. And that's why it's so great to have a dream journal beside your bed. When you get up, don't move. Write that dream down before you even get out of that bed, because those can give you lots of messages. It's powerful. And so that helps you ignite your authenticity. And then you're creating that life you love. So this is what my whole show premise was, to bring that to people. And so the experts that came on my show, oh my gosh, they were so wonderful. I have Tom T. Moore, who I absolutely adore. I've been following him for years. he does the gentle way. And the gentle way is the my most favorite prayer in the whole world. It's the most benevolent outcome prayer. And I use that all the time. And it's all, and this is the prayer. And it says, I say it my way. He says a little different, but you know, you always adapt. I ask all beings of light who are in service to me. I am asking for the most benevolent outcome to whatever's going on in your life, and be specific. Like, I have a nephew who he's 4 years old. He just had open heart surgery. And I said a prayer for him, and everybody's, you know, praying for him. I put it on the Facebook internet. And he is doing well. Literally, he has half a heart, and they had to like reorganize everything. He has organs misplaced, and he's doing well. I saw him in his mom's arms on a picture on Facebook yesterday. I was like so happy that he's, you know, because you don't always know if you're going to make it. So I say prayers like that. Bring in, help Mikey, and if this is for your highest good, even better than you can expect or hope for, thank you. So those are the kind of prayers, and you can say it for other people. You can say it for yourself. But always ask all beings of light who are in service to me, I am asking for, and you give the reason, if this is for my highest good, even better than I can expect or hope for, thank you. And your guides are right around you. They're ready to work with you all the time, but you have to ask. This is a free will planet. This is the universal law. You have to ask. And if you don't ask, they can't just step in and do it. People think it's because their angels are around them or your guides or whoever they are, the ancestors, the could be anybody. It could be an ET. We don't know who they are because we're from everywhere. We're multidimensional beings. So, you have to reach out to your guides and you have to ask specifically what's going on. What do I need here? This is what I need. And they will bring it to you. Mm-hmm. Oh, I had this gentleman I spoke to recently who is a person I was talking to from South Africa. He was a photographer. It's an amazing story. I just couldn't believe this story. He got into talking and connecting with his guides to meditation, and he asked the name and he got the name. And so then he's a photographer. He was going out to a big event in Johannesburg, and he was going to take pictures after a big soccer, the World Cup game, which is a huge event in soccer. And the fans are crazy mad fans. So you have to go in there with like trepidation sometimes because you don't know what's going to be going on. And there's a crush of people all the time because they're just so excited about this sport. They're really enthusiastic. So he went in and he took some pictures, and then he had this feeling he had to get out. So he said, I had to get out of the crowd. And all of a sudden he had this like little pouch around him where he had put his wallet, and it was zipped up and all carefully covered. And he said, I reached out and I realized it was gone. My wallet was gone. And I yelled out, my wallet's gone. Someone took my wallet. And he turns around and he sees it, like these little street kids behind him. He's going, oh boy, it could have been one of them, but I don't know. I can't blame anybody, you know? So he just said, all right, I'm just going out. And he started backing out. And then all of a sudden he got this little tap on the shoulder, and this little boy, one of the street urchins, handed him his wallet and said, here you are, sir. I got it back for you. He literally went back to this person. He followed the person. He must have seen it all happen because they're so aware, and brought him back his wallet. And I said, oh my gosh, that's like an amazing story. Yeah, yeah. Isn't it? And I said, this is such guidance. And when you ask for your guidance, and that's what happens, you know. I remember me once, newly in AA, and I was praying. I needed some money. And I'm like, okay, I really need $5,000 for this thing. I really needed this money. You know, my kids were getting older. I needed some help. My husband and I were it was just getting tight. And wouldn't you know, my in-laws decided to give us $5,000. I was like, oh my gosh, that really works. So, you know, it's like, this is the truth. And right now manifestation is happening. I mean, quickly. I mean, really, that's why you have to be so present with your thoughts, because when you're present, you have to really monitor your thoughts. So if you're going down the rabbit hole of negativity, you've got to look at it and go, all right, stop. I really don't want to go there. All right, back up. Where do I really want to go? And look at it and go, okay, this is what I want in my life. This is what I need in my life. And you get to have it when you do those things. You get to change these thoughts. You get to change your life all the time. We get to change it because we're in charge. We're responsible. I mean, you know, the ones we have been waiting for is us.
Right. This is the famous quote.
Yeah.
I want to speak into that. It's both, you know, the law of manifestation and the law of attraction. It's positive and negative. You can't expect only to get the positive back, but it is so important to pay attention to those synchronicities that start to happen in your life. And when you establish that direct connection with your divinity or with spirit or your higher self or whatever you want to call it, with God, you constantly get those cues and clues. And I had a really fun one the other day. As you know, it's a lot of long hours to design a show. I'm in that process right now. And I just needed a break. And for me, sometimes a break looks like watching something, like choosing something on the television. I don't watch normal television, but I have like Netflix and stuff. Like, I'm just going to turn it on and watch a little bit of something that'll lighten up. And I asked my guidance, what should I watch? And boom, right on the, you know, the first recommended title is Yes Man with Jim Carrey. Have you seen it?
Oh, that's great. Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, you know, I'm listening. I'll watch that. I don't know. You know, it looks funny and light. And so I watched it, and it had, you know, Jim Carrey's just masterful in his bringing comedy and spirituality together. But there, it was about this man who said no to everything in his life. And then he went to a seminar where his friend took him to the seminar. He's like, you got to start saying yes. And it was the yes, like saying yes to life seminar. So he started saying yes to everything. He thought he was hexed. And if he said no, something horrible would happen. So he had to say yes to absolutely everything. But it totally changed his life, saying yes. And then it's a spoiler, but at the end, he realizes the hex was all in his mind. There was no actual hex. Like, he could say no if he wanted to, but he learned to say yes, and then he had to learn to discern, when is it actually right for him to say yes versus are you saying yes because you have to? But it was such a metaphor for life, and it was, the delivery is very lighthearted, but it's like, for me, it was a deeply spiritual movie packaged in a fun comedy. And, you know, that's like, and that was just from me listening to guidance. Like, what would be in my best interest right now? I need a break. And it really did revive me. And, you know, and I got like, yes, I am saying yes to my life. I'm saying yes to opening up to whatever's next. And then those things get inserted step by step by step, if you're open to receiving them. And then you do have to discern, you know, is this right for me or if it isn't. But when you commit to that being a yes to your mission, to your purpose, to your life, the world is just an amazing, magical place. And I know that that's been your experience of opening up through this show and through all of the studying and the work and the energy work and the process that you've been doing. So what I'd love to know, and are you taking one-on-one clients? Is that?
Oh, sure. Absolutely.
Do you call that, is it coaching or is it energy work or a mixture?
It's a coaching mix, and it's a mixture. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, you have to put a label on it. So they say coaching, but it's really energy coaching, energy work, because when you're doing energy work, you are kind of coaching, you're kind of guiding, because you're, guiding. It's just part of it. It's just part of it.
Yeah. And so in that process of, I know part of what you do is help them open up to, you know, a bigger experience of connection. What are some of your clients experiencing through that process? I really like to hear about the transformations that people, you know, the opportunities, the transformation that people have. So what is a typical, or not typical, but an experience that someone could have through that work?
Well, I had one client who I had for a year, and she had lost everything in her business. Things had gone right down the drain, and she had never really truly opened up to her spiritual path. She was interested, but when she found out what I did, she said, okay, I have to work with you. And so she just started opening more and more and more. And I mean, it just changed her life in so much of a way that she's now out there. She's totally shifted what she did, which was business, into the spiritual coaching world. She's phenomenal with that work. She's helped people write books. She's helped people just develop their businesses, because she's really got a great business mind. So she's a great business coach, but she has such a spiritual part of it meshed into her work that it's just helped her grow this whole new type of business that she just didn't ever expect that she'd be into. So that's one of the clients, helping her open up to all that. And then other people would come to me, you know, just shifting their life, just saying, well, I came to you and because I opened up, I went to healing school. I didn't even know I would do that. Mm-hmm. And then other people say, well, I come to you with healing and yet I got to repair my relationship with my mom. Things in my life just shifted with her, you know, because I opened up differently. I listened in a different way. I was coming from my heart. I learned to go into my heart and say, okay, it's not, I can't blame her for everything because that's all she knew at the time. Mm-hmm. And so now I can listen to her and look at her from a different way without the shame and the blame of everything that's all her fault, you know, because it isn't necessarily all her fault because you come in with these lessons in your life that you're meant to learn because you create that before you come into this life, which is how I understand it. And when you come in, people that come into you, your soul group is always around you. That's your family. And they're the ones who are going to bring you this lesson. They're the most intimate ones that are going to bring you this lesson. So it may not be in a way you expected. It's not going to be the comfortable way because you're living in 3D at the time. And that lesson is going to come in ways you don't expect. So it could be difficult. It could be hard. And it could be harsh because it's trying to awaken you back onto your spiritual path to remember who you are. I mean, this whole life is about remembering who we are because we are spiritual essences having a physical experience. Mm-hmm. And because we're all parts of God, we're all sparks of God because we're all one. And so when you're from source, we're all one because we're all connected energetically and we're source on earth having a physical experience. So when you understand that and this connected to this woman, it opened up her life and her whole, you know, everything changed and she shifted. And, you know, I mean, just people, I mean, I had people when I used to do a lot of holistic events, I mean, I'd have long lines of people coming for healing work. And one woman would say, oh, I've come to you once a year because that's all I need. And I'm like, really? Yeah, because I know that I get this work I need with you and I'm good for the year. And I said, well, that's interesting. That's really powerful because I didn't know that. And then, you know, people don't always understand what's going on in their life. Like I had someone call me up a while ago and she said, you know, I realized when my life shifted was after I worked with you, Janet. And I said, well, thank you. And she does chiropractic. And she said, well, I'd love my clients to start coming to see you. So, you know, things like that start happening. And, you know, just many different ways that people have had, you know, experiences. And yeah, that's what I can think of at the moment about that. But, you know, I love when you said how, when you say yes to things, that is, it is important to do because I know, I mean, for years I was so afraid to, you know, break out of the box. So, you know, years and years of fear because of growing up in the dysfunction and not having trust. And it's all about not having trust as well, because when you're with people that you love and they're not loving you in the way you were expecting, you lose that trust in your life. So now here I had to learn how to trust again. And so now when you said, say yes, and also you can hear that it's a yes, but like you said, you have to say, is this the right time for me to do this? Because sometimes you can say yes, but it's not yet the exact time. It's going to come in the right moment that's right for you. So it could be right, some of it, but not all of it. You know what I mean? So, because I love to do it all. I mean, I'm a person who loves to do it all. So I have to look at that and say, okay, do I have to do this now? Maybe I have to wait and do this part first. But every time I took that step and took that challenge on and broke through that barrier, it gave me so much more courage and so much more strength to go forward and know that I'm limitless. I don't have anything holding me back but me. And so this world, this year is all about building that foundation and then get into, you know, get ready for your expansion because it's coming. It's coming. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you set your parameters and you set your foundation to what you really want in your life. And this month right now is really still about more clearing work because 2019 is still lingering with all these eclipse work and everything. But it's so important to do some deep work and clear that energy that you're working, you know, that you're stuck in and get it out and keep going, you know, get it out and work with someone if you need it for guidance or, you know, just sit and meditate, journal. You know, write your dreams down, you know, you've got to get this out because, and then you can move into this higher energy that's waiting for us because it's here and we're going to be living side by side next to 3D energy, 5D and 3D. We're right here together. But when you're in the heart-based energy, you don't always get attracted to that 3D stuff anymore, because it doesn't, it's not the vibration that you're in anymore. It's not the frequency. So it's not calling you to go there anymore. You may look at things, you may look at yourself and go, how come those friends don't intrigue me anymore? How come I don't want to be with them anymore? I mean, these things are changing. So when you look at your life, and don't be hard on yourself, because it's probably a good thing. It's probably a good thing. And you're going to meet even better people. You're going to meet people more in line with what you really want in your life. And so when you open up to those things, it, as you said, it'll come. It'll come to you.
Yes, it will. It does. And also important is that 2020 is a four, and it's a heart. That's the number of the heart. Four is the number of the heart chakra, the fourth energy center of the body. And it really is a big opportunity to expand that heart energy. And part of that is forgiveness and releasing old traumas, so that you can open up the heart space and have, you know, a greater interaction with the divinity and with your higher self, and then embody that. And I think, you know, part of the release that 2019 was doing and continues in 2020, if there's still more, and there's always more, you know,
we're, right,
we're, life's going to keep lifing, but to keep opening, you know, and to, we, the energy to open the heart is so big this year, in this 2024 year. And so to just, you know, like, just know that all of that work is worth it, and keep expanding out and connecting. I find this the year of, like, so much community and connection and collaboration. And I feel like the time of feeling lonely and being alone, we don't have to do it alone anymore. I mean, it's time to collaborate. Mm-hmm. Which is why shows like this happen, right?
It's true. It's true. And I love what you said about the fourth heart chakra. I never thought of that. I love that. Mm-hmm. That is so true. Mm-hmm. It's our fourth. It's our heart opening.
Yeah. It is. And so, speaking of collaboration, I understand that you've done a book collaboration called Women Let's Rise. Tell us about that project.
Yeah, this is really exciting. You know, I was always told, you're going to write a book, you're going to write a book, but you know, I've never written a book. So this opportunity came up, and I said, you know what, it's a chapter. I could totally handle a chapter of writing a book. So I said, yes. And so this book is about women stepping up, you know, with the new energies, and, you know, so much attention is coming to women. The feminine energy is coming out into the world. I mean, people and women are starting to be totally regarded for their contributions to society and what they've gone through to get to where they are. So this book really brings in, for all the different women that are in it, there's 21 of us, and everyone's bringing in their life experience, what went on that got them to where they are, how they got on their path, and how they've risen above it. Because I don't think women are recognized enough for what they bring to society. I mean, we're always such supporters. Women are supporters. We're the love. We're really the foundation in our families, because we're the love connection. Because the men, we love you men. I mean, the men are wonderful, but, you know, they're very analytical, and they're in their head, and they're very logical, and the women are the heart-based. So we are, it's connecting now. We're connecting both. We're balancing that both in our energies. That's what this new energy is all about, the age of Aquarius, the male and the female, in all of us, the male, the women and the men, balancing that energy. But this book brings in, you know, the women and their, and what they've gone on in their life and their stories, and how they've risen above it, and where they're going, and how they just have so much to offer. And, you know, you look at how many women are starting to show up in Congress, all these younger women stepping up in political arenas. We need this new energy. We need women's energy, because women bring the heart in it, into it. And so men are brilliant. They're very structured. They're very logical. We need the male energy too, but we need to balance them out so that we can both, you know, connect together. We need to be respected. Women need to be respected, because we see how, you know, they're looked at in different ways in society, even now, which is, you know, still happening. And so these awarenesses are coming through in this book. So that's what women are bringing through this journey we've all been on, and what we can offer to people. We're all bringing through different, you know, everyone does different kinds of things. We're not all healers. There's all kinds of people writing the book, all ages. And everyone has their life experience for where they are right now, bringing it through, and how that they're rising above it. And it's just kind of a book of courage in a lot of way too, that, you know, people can look at the women and say, this is an inspiration to me, because mm-hmm. women are stepping up. We really are. And it's been happening for 20 years, but now it's really coming to a culmination where it's really like, it's right there. There's no ignoring it. Women are not going to be ignored anymore. Take a look at us. We're here. We're a force to be reckoned with as well. And we want to work with you. We don't want to work against you. As you said, it's collaborative energies. We all are here to work together. We are a unified force. We're a unified field. And when we get into that balance, we can bring so much to this planet. We can shift this planet. And it's not going to take that long if we get into this energy and work it all together. It's going to be amazing what happens. So they say the next 20 years, we're not going to know the world we live in now. It's going to change and shift so much.
Yeah. You know, it is, it's so true. I do believe that the balance of the masculine and the feminine is really a strong energy now on the planet. And that is, you know, there's still the play that's going on, the back and forth, but it first happens from within each person. So when we go within and balance that masculine and feminine within us, and we honor both equally, you know, that's the yin and the yang, that's the dark and the light working together. That is the foundation of creation. One is not more or less than the other. It's equality. And so I feel like we're doing that first internally. And then when enough people, like you said, the 100-monkey effect, when enough people have had that balance happen internally, which I call the twin flame integration, then the external world will have to reflect that, because that's the way it works. We do our internal work and then the external world reflects it, or we don't do our internal work and then the external world reflects that back. And I really do see that playing out now. You know, it's kind of like the last, like it things become more dramatized when something's ending. The end of the patriarchal era is here, and you can see it in the media just like crashing and burning in a big way now as it's things true. Begin to right. You know, it's like the pendulum swings all the way out here and then it comes back into the center.
Well, yes, and everything is created from chaos, and so the universe started in chaos. So when we see this chaos going in the world, that famous saying, be in the world but not of the world. You can be the observer of it, but don't take it in, don't embrace it. Keep connecting to that inner self, like you're saying, that self-love, which is my whole premise, self-loving yourself, learning to love yourself. Then you're balancing your masculine and feminine. Exactly what you said, we're bringing it back out and we're creating. That's creation right there. I love that. That was beautiful. That was really well said. Mm-hmm. And I find that the chaos going on is all telling us to... This change happening. Now, which way do we want it to go? And we have that decision to make as well. Do you want it to go in a way of peace and harmony in the planet? Do you want to bring women up into this level of equality? Do you want the environment to be saved? You know, there's lots of crazy things happening, which I didn't even know was happening. I just came to the awareness that there's someone burning water. Could you imagine that they're burning water on our planet? There's a company that's burning water for energy or something. And this is crazy. You can't burn water. And fracking is hurting our planet so badly because it's causing the earthquakes, and they don't even understand that it's causing the earthquakes. And the warning is out, like Mother Earth is getting angry at us, because that's why these fires are happening in Australia. That's why these earthquakes are happening in Philippines. They're happening. Actually, there's a volcanic eruption going on in the Philippines right now. And Puerto Rico just had their earthquakes. The earth is angry. She wants us to stop messing with the natural courses that she's taking to clear the planet. And as I understand it, that, you know, people say, I just read something that Mars did the same thing. That's why Mars is a red planet. They used to burn water for energy. So now they're a dead planet and we can't be there. We can do that to ourselves. So everybody, if you're an environmentalist, get on the horn about that one. Don't start learning about this burning water. I mean, and we just have to be vocal, and we have to be, you know, sending out the compassion, the love. I mean, you can just send out the energy of like, no more, No more. We don't need this. And say the most benevolent outcome prayer. I call it the MBO. And ask the guides to come in and help us to stop these people from doing these things. I mean, you can do it in meditation, prayer. You don't have to be an activist, but there's ways to go out and, you know, help our planet as well. And I was just amazed when I read this about burning water, because they said if you burn the water, they're literally going into the aquifers. If they burn those, we have no water on our planet. This is serious stuff. They are not fooling around. So I am just amazed to hear that. This has just came up yesterday. I'm like, what? This is incredible. And why would someone even think of such a thing? Why would you burn water, which is such a valuable resource? So without it, we can't live.
Yeah. Well, you know, I think it comes back when I hear something like that. The way that I take that is, it comes back to each individual going within and finding that balance and finding what's right. And I think if enough of us do that self-centering and get clear on, you know, coming from the heart, coming from kindness, coming from a desire to be of benefit to the planet, to other people, eventually, you know, it's going to right itself. And I do want to speak into that. You know, there is this whole, my daughter's an activist. She's studying geology in college, and she is a strong activist. And I love that. And I've been an earth activist my whole life. So I speak, you know, with my heart for the earth always. And what I want to say is, I had a speaker on the other day, Elizabeth Wood, who talked about this, and I absolutely loved it, is the earth is such a conscious being, way beyond the consciousness of us as humans. And she is hosting us as our mother here. And she wants us here, and she loves us, and she's giving, you know, she's giving herself to us in her ascension process. She is giving us the opportunity to ascend with her, which is why we have all of these wonderful ascension energies available to us now. And she knows how to right the wrongs that are happening. She can, in one breath, she could wipe us all out if she wanted to. She knows how to do that. She knows how to balance herself. She has all of the energy she needs because her guides and her peers are the other planets and all of creation, all of space. She has that all at her hands. And she's allowing our sort of our drama to play out, just like us as parents allow our toddlers to have their fits, you know, sometimes in a grocery store because they want a piece of candy that we're not buying for them, or sometimes just because they're tired. And we can look at them compassionately and say, that's okay, you know, work that out and then get up and let's move on. And that's how I look at it. You know, that stuff is happening and we all have our piece in it and our contribution. We can all help, but I don't get overly upset about it. Number one, because I can't personally change it. What I can do is change me. And I can help change the consciousness of other people by bringing an awareness to, okay, if that's not, you know, if you're not doing the thing that's right for your heart and the earth, that's not going to feel good. And let's get into our bodies and feel them and know what feels right. And they will lead us in the right direction when we're honoring them. And the same is true for all of life. And when we learn to honor the earth more and appreciate the sun, the earth, the sky, all of the energies, the water, and we fall in love with it, we're not going to want to harm it. We're not going to want to use plastics. We're not going to want to, you know, create garbage on our planet. We're going to want to clean it up. We're going to want to find free energies that are clean and support those, even though they might cost more in the beginning, you know. And it's just this consciousness of love your earth and invest in her the way that you invest in your children and your grandchildren, and the way that you invest in anything that you appreciate, because she is working with us and she is our mother here and she's supporting us. And we're all rising together.
And I agree with everything you said. And I think that's so beautifully said. And yes, and I just feel like it's nice to know some of these things that are going on, and I know I get a little passionate about it. So I know,
and that's fine. Don't feel judged at all.
Yeah. It's okay. I'm not. I'm just thinking about okay, and you're right, and it's and we can just go in our own way and to just bring it into ourselves, as I said, and say prayers and send good energy.
Mm, yes,
it's not to send them anger, but to send them good energy, because I understand Mother Gaia can balance herself out. But, you know, we also have to help her because we have a consciousness too that she connects with. So we have to help her.
Absolutely.
So we have to be aware that there are things that we can do. So this is what you're putting out, and me, we're putting out awarenesses to people to be aware that these things are happening. And you don't have to go out and go change that necessarily yourself, but inner work, like you're saying, exactly right, and also praying for these things to help them to stop, to bring them a higher consciousness, to know that it's not helping our mother, because she is here to nurture and love us, and she only wants the best for us, and she doesn't want us to leave because she doesn't have to keep us here to survive. It's really our choice to learn to honor her, to stay here and be here. And I know right now we're all these things are waking us up in lots of ways. And so these are more wake up calls. So what, you know, it's inner work reflects the outer work. Like you're saying, it's the inner, the, you know, macro to the micro to the macro. When you go in and you go out, you can, it'll reflect out the same, like you said, energy of the pebble in the pond. It just keeps reflecting out, and we just go in, do the inner work, and it'll reflect out and bring it to the earth, and she will calm down, and these people will calm down, and they'll just realize their consciousness will shift. And they'll go, oh yeah, this may not be a good idea. So this is all I'm asking for. And like you're asking, is to say the prayers, send them good energy, change it. Be in your heart when you're doing this work and realize that this can stop now. It's time to stop. So it's just time to stop. And that would help.
Yeah, there is a saying, we don't see the world as it is. We see the world as we are.
Exactly.
And that is the reflection. You know, when you find that peace within yourself, you find that peace on the outside. That doesn't mean you won't see things that are happening. Mm-hmm. For me, I don't watch news and I don't listen to the radio, but of course I get information. I know what's going on because my view is people will tell me, I talk to people, they'll tell me what's going on if I need to know, kind of like a need to know basis, because there are so many things going on in the world and dramas playing out because the people in those places are having those dramas. The things around me that I can change, I will do things to change. Absolutely. And when I see a cause that speaks to my heart and pulls me in, and I know that it's my place to put my energy there and contribute, I will, like, for instance, the burning in Australia. I have a different take on it than a lot. I'm not praying for rain because I know that the earth knows when it's the right time to rain. I don't know that, you know, I can't choose that for that place. That's not mine to do, but I will donate money. I can't go there right now in my life, I have donated money to the cause of the people that are there rescuing the animals and doing what they can to put out the fires. And, you know, like there's a lot of intense stuff going on there. And I feel for that, that calls to my heart. I made a meditation and put that online to support people that are in stress. But I don't pray for rain because I don't know what the higher picture is. If it's supposed to rain, it will rain when it's the right time. You know, I believe that. I believe that the earth knows. And for whatever reason, there's a clearing, a fire clearing going on there. And when
there is a fire,
I wash that away, it will happen. That's not for me to choose. But I can pray for the best for all of the beings there. I can pray for the best for everybody that's suffering and in stress and all the animals there. But, you know, that's kind of my take on it. I can't change that. So
no, what we it is actually, there are flooding. It's actually flooding in areas. You know, only reason I know is because I have a friend who had a son in Puerto Rico. I have my assistant lives in the Philippines, and she actually sent me a picture of the volcanic eruption where she is. So that's why I know, and I don't listen to the news either.
Yeah,
and what was the last one I said? The earthquake, the volcano, and the fire. Yeah, and I have a lot of connection in Australia because I used to live there.
Really?
So, I lived there in the 80s for 2.5 years, and I was there again in 2017. So I have a lot of connection there, and I've been talking to a lot of people in Australia lately. Mm-hmm. And so they've been telling me what's going on. So I have been having firsthand information. So it's amazing how, you get this information. And there was a huge prayer group out for rain. Well, and what you're saying makes a lot of sense, because they did say that the fires are a natural burn off. The earth needed to do this burning, and this is something that we haven't allowed to happen, because before there were so many people on the earth, these natural fires would occur. And even the Aborigines do natural fire burnings in the outback to clear the land, and then it allows the seeds and the new plants to come up and sprout. So this is a natural burning, and I've heard that. And yet, but so many people are in the way of it, and the animals, that, you know, people get nervous. But there is rain now to a point in some places that they're flooding, I've heard.
Wow.
So that's now happening. And then there was also something about, there's a perimeter around the waters of Australia that people aren't allowed to come into the country because the government set that up. So it's not, the energy of that was not allowing people to come in, and not allowing rain to come in either, or water. So because people couldn't come in from water, the energy of that was also stopping the rain from coming. So it's so interesting that you hear, you know, so many ways that the world, you know, the earth is expressing herself, and Mother Gaia is expressing herself. But, you know, it's all happening as it needs to be. And we just pray for the people in the way, and the things are happening because a lot of us are meant to experience it. My friend whose son was in the Puerto Rico, he was 24, the first time he was there, and he said it was an unbelievable experience. The whole house shook. He said it was incredible. Mm-hmm. And they were going to go to the ocean and have a nice week at the ocean, but they couldn't because of tsunami warning. So then he had to not go there. And now he's home safe, but my friend was very distressed because it was such a new experience for her to have family there. And it's just interesting how we're all having these experiences, and that we're meant to have them in some way to have the compassion for everyone else in the world that are going through it.
Yeah.
So these connections are making us more of a community, a unified field of people. You know, we're not just countries anymore. If we can look at ourselves as a planet of people, it's so powerful because
absolutely
we're so connected. But I can keep talking. So
yeah. No, we're out of time. And just with one last thing I want to say about that, do support, you know, if something calls to your heart, and, you know, for me, I see the sweet koalas and kangaroos and I want to support the effort to save them, you know? So it's whatever it is for you. If something calls to you, there are lots of places that, that you can reach out and support in various ways. If you have extra money or something calls to your heart, do that. You know, I completely encourage people to do that. So before we end, I want to tell everyone you're offering this amazing free gift of 30-minute divine light activation call one-on-one with you.
Yes.
And I mean, how often do we get a free one-on-one call with somebody? That's such a generous offer. So tell us a little bit about what that is.
Yeah. And it's a great call because, and I hope, you know, when you come, please show up, because that's the most important thing, is to show up, because you can book the call and then just push it off. But I will say the most important thing in life to show up for things. So when you commit to it, I do some energy work with you. You get answers. You get some clearing. It's amazing. And people have had extraordinary results. I will say I have a number of people I've been working with, and it's just been phenomenal what they're getting. And so you will get something from it, and it's going to really help you in forward in your path this year. So I'm doing it from the heart. It's all heart-based energy for you. I'm here, you know, in service and self-love to help you bring that into you. And I just hope you join me.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Janet. You are bringing your heart and your light and your work to this planet and to everybody on it to help uplift all of us. And we're all working on this ascension together. Mm-hmm. And I appreciate you and your energy and your time and this conversation. So thank you so much for your contribution. I really appreciate you.
And thank you too, Waxela. You have so much wisdom. I love what you were sharing too. And thank you for this beautiful work you're doing and bringing to the planet and to people. because this is what, you know, this is the service that the self-love that we bring to everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. It's all about self-love. And it's my pleasure to do that. And so with that, I'm going to say goodbye to everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in and watching. Be sure to get Janet's free gift if you want to take, you know, like take on self-love or empower yourself in a new way or experience an activation with her. Jump on that. And the link to that is in today's email. And also, if there was something in this conversation that was impactful to you, if you had an aha moment or something really made you think, respond to the email that you received today and just let me know what that was. And I will share your comments and your feedback with Janet. And so with that, I want to say have a wonderful day or evening wherever you are, and namaste.
Namaste.